Today, I want to take this opportunity to review a very successful trade on GNS. It was a multi-day runner that was identified as one of the pre-market runners, and at the time of this video, it had gained over 400%. I get a lot of DMs asking me, how do I trade this type of stock? There are many questions where I should enter. How do I size my position? Where do I take profits? How do I set my stop loss? These are all great questions, and the aim of this video is to break down the movement of the stock, identify key areas where we can accumulate our position with relatively small risk, and identify the trend looking at moving averages, the momentum. Let's do it. So first of all, stock had a massive relative volume in the pre-market. I've made a video on the volume and on creating your morning watch list. So if you haven't seen it, go and watch it. Great stuff. At the time of making that watch list, the stock has made a new high, which was around 81 cents over here. But it pulled back. And it start, you know, trying to, first it tried to sort of reverse, but it failed. And that was around 74 cents level. Then it pulled back and start making new highs here. So what ended up on my watch list was two potential entries. One being the break of this key pivot level. So that was the area of resistance. There was a potential here to accumulate your position. Right, but I wanted to have a little bit more confirmation, so I wanted it to cross this pivot level. And if it did, your stop loss, as always, is at the low swing low level. So stop loss would have been here around 66, 67 cents. But then it broke out, right? And then it made a move here to in the pre-market high already 92 cents. So that alone. That move alone would give you around 24% gain, which is great. So following that run here towards the 92 cent level, it needed to consolidate. And during the market open, it was expected that it would pull back because some people that stayed overnight would take some profits, and it did. But it found support here around 74 cents level. But again, made a new pivot here. So the great area to accumulate here, if you haven't got in earlier, would have been right here around 86 cents level with the stop loss around 74. And what we see here is when it did break, right, it pushed hard to a new high around 98. So we could assume that the around dollar level would have been a psychological resistance, which it was. But then it pulled back here to the 20-day line, which you can see in blue. And then after short consolidation, it showed up again and it made a new high at around 110. Okay. And look at that price action. I want to point out here the yellow line, as you can see here, is the 8-day line, right? I use this to gauge what sort of momentum the stock is having, right? And it was kind of, you can see, glued to that line only, you know, sort of only here briefly. It pulled back and tried to pull back to 20-day line. And as you can see over here, it went below, but it stayed relatively tight. So I drew the line over here, the trend line sort of resistance, and we can see descending triangle. And often what happens with these high momentum stocks, you know, we get a break when the price actions gets really tight and, you know, it's time for a decision. So the great place to add would be here when we saw this price action, you know, around this level, around dollar level, right? With your stop loss just below here, around 98. And look, it shot up again. Made a new high here around 126. So that's already would have been 26% gain. And then you look how tight the consolidation is, right? Huge volume on the buying side, but a very little selling on the pullbacks, right? So that kind of information, that little selling gives you indication there's a lot more buyers than sellers, and it's still okay to stay. A little after that, we got another shot up here to a new high of 166, right? Again, you know, we've got some more selling happening over here, but still within the trend, right? Only pull back to 20-day line to sort of reclaim the high of the day and go even higher. And so this is another key area, right? As we went higher, still glued to that 8-day line, we made a new high right over here. Okay, 198. So another, remember, a dollar level, okay? Psychological resistance, now $2 level, and we pull back again. And this time, we even halted down below the 20-day line. And that, you know, that should you put you on a defense, right? So in the past, you were thinking like, you know, okay, where I'll, you know, where, how high can it go? And now you are on a defense. So you're thinking like, where I need to be securing my profits. All right. So after we got halted down, we opened up lower, pulled back to the 160 area, and then we shot back up again, right? Making new high to 216. And, you know, it was a bit exhausted, right? It already had a massive run. So, you know, on the break of, I'd say, sort of this level right over here, after two big candles, you know, that's where you would kind of secure your profits and continue watching, right? Because it had a lot of momentum that day. And this is what we saw exactly here, right? Sort of pull back. Still, it tried to reverse here, but then it got sort of sold down more. Couldn't break that level again here, as you can see, right? But only here, after it found support around 140, it kind of started consolidating, right? It broke here through that pivot and that pivot, and again broke through this pivot, but it kind of then got sold off and then consolidated. But I want you to pay attention to how tightly this price action is, okay? And if we remove those lines and draw this line over here, we can see that this is trendline resistance. And again, on the sort of support side, you can see that this is forming now wedge, right? And I think this is where I've alerted an entry of 165 as well. And that would have been perfect place to add, right? Look, price got tighter, didn't have anywhere to go, and it broke out, okay? Took out this key pivot level here, okay? And then it consolidated for a bit, okay? Very little selling again, and then it shot up here, taking out the new high of the, taking out the high of the day, okay? And again, new high of the day at 220, pull back just before the market close to a 190 level, and again sort of made these now glued to the 50-day line, and again wedge formed, and again broke out in the pre-market to 242. Moving along very nicely over here, once again, you know, sort of pull back. Kind of similar story. If you look at that wedge here, pull back, found a support at around $2.05, and then showed up again. And it continued the same in the same fashion for the rest of the pre-market, making a new high at 308. Right? What a massive runner. And again, like I said, these were the key areas where you could have added, you know, accumulated some position here, with the clear stop loss around here. Similar story over here with the stop loss being over here. If you were in the position from, you know, from the early from early, what you would do, you simply move your stop loss up as we break and making new highs. Okay? So let's say you've entered around here, then you know, you just continue moving a stop loss up as we're making new highs. And this way, you can stay in that trade for way longer, be more profitable, secure profits on the way up, and follow the simple rule. Don't try to buy the bottom and don't try to sell at the top. Just follow the trend, watch the moving averages, and then, you know, maximize your returns. But also exit when the time, you know, when it's not, when, you know, when the trend is breaking. Hope this was helpful. Make sure to follow for more updates and videos. Thanks very much. Talk to you next time.